So Microsoft has officially stopped support for Windows 10, which means you won't be getting any updates, even security updates, unless you enroll in the Extended Security Updates program that they've made available for one more year until October 13, 2026. So in this video, I'm going to show you exactly what options you have of enabling the Windows 10 Extended Security Updates. I'm going to take you through a step-by-step process of what I'll be doing on a Windows 10 PC to get the Windows 10 Extended Security Updates for another year. And then hopefully that'll help you decide if you want to do it too, or if you're just struggling to get it enabled, this guide will be helpful to you too. Now, at the time of recording this video, there is a bit of confusion and a difference in how the Windows 10 ESU program works in the US and in Europe. Here, I've got two articles from Microsoft. One is from ENUS, and then the other article is for Europe, for the European Economic Area. Now, if we look at these two articles, specifically at how much Windows 10 ESU costs, on the ENUS page, Microsoft says that you can enroll in one of the following three ways: at no additional cost if you're syncing your PC settings, or you can redeem 1,000 Microsoft rewards points, or a one-time purchase of $30 or your local currency equivalent plus applicable tax. But if we go over to the EU page and we have a look at how much Windows 10 ESU costs there, according to Microsoft, then we get a whole different explanation. So in the European Economic Area, you can get it in one of the following ways after you sign in with a Microsoft account. So it says that users have to stay signed in to the eligible PC with a Microsoft account, and then the Microsoft account used to sign into the ESU enrollment tool will enable extended security updates on the device through to 13 October 2026, as long as you continue signing into Windows with your Microsoft account that you use to enroll. If you do not continue to sign into your PC with the Microsoft account, then the updates will be discontinued for that device after a period of time, up to 60 days. And if the ESU updates have been discontinued for failing to sign in with your Microsoft account, you'll need to re-enroll to resume the updates. For users who do not want to use a Microsoft account, who wants to use a local account, they need to do the one-time purchase of $30, and this allows you continued use of a local account and doesn't require you to sign in with a Microsoft account to keep the updates other than to make the purchase. So you can make this purchase through the Microsoft Store, but basically this means you'll still have to temporarily sign in with a Microsoft account just to get the updates. And then this will enable extended security updates on the device until the cutoff date, which is 13 October 2026. So basically what I can gather from this is if you're living in the European Economic Area, the moment you sign in with a Microsoft account, I think it'll automatically enroll you into the extended security updates program for Windows 10. You won't have to go and do these tasks like syncing your PC settings or redeeming 1,000 Microsoft reward points. But you will need to continue signing into the PC with that Microsoft account. Now, I've thought about this, and I think if you want to continue using Windows 10 and you want to continue using a local account and keep the extended security updates, the best way is going to be to have two user accounts on your computer. One is going to be a Microsoft account that you're going to sign into every once in a while, every month or so, just to keep the security updates on that computer. And then the other one is going to be your local account that you'll use for everyday purposes. So that's going to be your main account. The Microsoft account is just going to be there for the extended security updates. And that also means that your data and your files and stuff in your local account won't be synced or shared to Microsoft, because that's tied to a completely different user account than the Microsoft account. So with all of that being said, let me now show you how you can enroll into the Windows 10 Extended Security Updates program for free. So as you can see, I'm on a Windows 10 PC, and if I navigate to the settings and then go to Update and Security, you can see that I get this message that says your version of Windows has reached the end of support and that it's no longer receiving security updates. Now, I also don't have the option of enrolling into the Extended Security Updates program anywhere in the UI here. Usually here on the right side, or just even in the middle here, you'll have an option of enrolling. But if you don't have the option, like I don't have here, then I'm going to show you how to get it. But before I get to that, this is only going to work if you're on Windows 10 22H2. So if I go to the About section and I show you the version, it has to be Windows 10 version 22H2. And then also, if you go to Update and Security, you have to have all of the latest updates installed. As you can see, I don't have any updates available to install here because it says the version of Windows has reached the end of support. Now, if I click on Home and go to the normal settings page, you can see that I'm signed in with a local account. And this is the primary account that I want to use on this computer. So I'm not going to convert this local account to a Microsoft account. Instead, what I'm going to do is go to the Accounts tab and then go to Family and Other Users. And then I'm going to add someone else to this PC, which will prompt me to sign in with a Microsoft account. So I'm going to add an additional user account to this computer, which is going to be a Microsoft account, and I'll keep my local account intact. So I'm just going to enter my email address here, then click on Next, and then you'll see we're good to go. To log in for the first time, I'll have to enter the password when I select that user account. So I'll just click on Finish. Now, before you sign into this account, you need to change the account type of this user from a standard user to an administrator, or else you won't be able to enroll into the extended security updates. So just change it to an administrator and then click on OK. And now it'll be an administrator. Once that's done, you can close it. Click on the Start button, select the accounts, and now we're going to sign into the Microsoft account that we created. So you'll need to click on Sign In. And now it's going to prompt us to enter the password for that Microsoft account. So if you don't have a Microsoft account yet, you can just go online and create one. You don't even have to use your primary email address. This email address you see here is not something I use. It's something I use to record videos. So this is basically like a dummy email address. But if you don't have a Microsoft account yet, just go online and create a Microsoft account using a browser. But I'm going to enter my password here. Now it prompts us to create a PIN, so we have to do that. I'm just going to click on Next, and then I'm just going to create a simple PIN here. Once that's done, just click on OK, and now we'll load into that Microsoft account. Just decline this ad, all of these ads from Microsoft. Turn off all of the data collection. And now we're finally loaded into the Microsoft account. So now that we're signed into the Microsoft account, we need to use the registry editor to give ourselves the option of enrolling into the extended security updates. So to do that, you just do a search for RegEdit and then click on it to open it. Then you'll navigate to HKEY Current User, Software, Microsoft, then scroll all the way down until you get to Windows NT, expand that, then expand current version, and then lastly expand Windows. Now we're going to have to create one new registry key and then two registry values. Now all of these registry entries I'm also going to include in my written guide that you can find on my website, and I'll also include a link to that in the description of this video, just so it's easier for you to copy and paste the actual value names. But to get started, you'll need to right click on the Windows folder, then select New Key. And you want to call this key consumer ESU, and it has to be spelled exactly like that. Then you can just press enter to create it. Then next, you want to right click on the consumer ESU key, select new DWORD 32-bit value, and you want to call that value ESU eligibility. Then press enter. Once that's created, you can double click on it to open it. And then you want to change the value data to 2 and then click on OK. Then once again, go to the consumer ESU key, right click on it, select new DWORD 32-bit value. Then this time you want to call it ESU eligibility result and then press enter. So once you've created that one, double click on it to open it and then just change the value data to 1. And click on OK. So now that we've done that, we can close the registry editor. Then we can navigate to the settings and then update and security. And now we'll have the option to enroll in the extended security updates. So now that we have this option, we can just click on enroll now. And then we'll get this wizard to enroll into the extended security updates. So I'll just click on next. Now you'll see that I'm eligible to enroll in the extended security updates at no extra cost. And this is the only option I get. I don't even get the option to pay $30 or to have my settings synced with backup or whatever. We just have this one option, and I'm gonna click on enroll, and it's then gonna enroll this device in the extended security updates. So as we can see, I'm enrolled in the extended security updates through to October 13, 2026. And this PC that's signed in with this account is enrolled to receive extended security updates. So if I go and sign in on another Windows 10 computer with this account, then I'll also be able to enroll in the extended security updates on that computer using the same account. Because if I'm not mistaken, you can have 10 devices running on one account that has the extended security updates linked to that account. So as you can see, Microsoft suggests that we make sure that our PC is fully backed up. I'm not going to do that. I'm just going to click on done, and then it's going to close that window. So now you can see that the PC is enrolled to get extended security updates, and this is inside our Microsoft account. But we don't want to use the Microsoft account for everyday use. So I'm going to sign out of it. I'm going to sign back in to the local account, which is the account that I want to use for everyday use. And if I now navigate to the settings and then update and security, it still says that the version of Windows has reached the end of support and that it's not receiving security updates. But this is because it's a local account. But you have to remember that Windows updates are not installed per user. They're installed on the entire machine. So basically on the local account, you're just going to ignore this message. When you want to check for updates, you're going to log into your Microsoft account, the one we created specifically to get the extended security updates. You're going to log into that account. Then you're going to go to settings, update and security, and then you're going to check for updates because the PC is enrolled to get extended security updates. But because that other account is a local account, it's not going to show you that message because Microsoft requires a Microsoft account. And OneDrive is crashing in typical fashion because it's just bad and it doesn't work. But this is what I would do on a Windows 10 computer that I'm going to be using for daily use. Every 2 weeks or once a month or so, whenever Microsoft releases these security updates, probably every 2 weeks is going to be safer, I would just log into this Microsoft account. I'd come to check for updates, see if any updates are available. If there are any security updates, let the Microsoft account install it for the PC, for the entire computer. And then once it's done and it says that you're up to date because your PC is enrolled to get security updates, then you can just simply log out of your Microsoft account, sign out of it, forget about it for the next 2 weeks or next month, however long you want to forget about it, and go ahead and use your local account as you've been doing the entire time. Because it doesn't matter what the update and security page says here in the local account, this is inaccurate. It's only saying this because you're not signed into a Microsoft account on this user. But your PC will still be protected because Windows updates are installed system-wide. It's not installed per user. So by doing it this way, your Windows 10 PC should stay safe and secure for the next year until the extended security updates program also runs out. And then also, you are playing by Microsoft's rules that require you to sign in with the Microsoft account that you used to enroll into the ESU program. And then you won't lose the updates for that year or after 60 days or whatever period of time it may be, because you are actually signing into your Microsoft account on a regular basis. But that Microsoft account is completely separate from your local account, and it doesn't have access to the local account's data, to its files or whatever. So your privacy on the local account is still intact, and you're only using the Microsoft account for the actual extended security updates and to get that installed on your computer. And if you feel that this is too much hassle for you, or you just don't want to do it, then I recommend that you just upgrade to Windows 11. I've got plenty of guides on my channel on how to do that, even on unsupported hardware. And if your computer is just that old that it doesn't support Windows 11, then maybe it's just time to buy a new computer, or maybe install Linux on that computer. But if you move over to Windows 11, I've created a tool called Winhance, which will enhance your Windows 11 experience and just make it not as bad as it is straight out of the box. And you can watch the videos I've created on that on this channel, and I'll link those at the end of this video. But let me know what you think down in the comments below. Are you still using Windows 10? Are you using the extended security updates? Or are you already on Windows 11 and you just don't care about what's happening with Windows 10? I'd like to know what my community thinks of all of this. But with that being said, I really hope this video was helpful to you. If it was, please consider liking the video and subscribing to the channel. And as always, I just want to give a special shout out to all of my YouTube members. Thanks so much for your support. I really appreciate it. And I'll talk to all of you guys soon.